congratulations on your win.
Yes, I'm afraid.
Do you have a fight name?
We keep going over this. There's a bit of bunch thrown out, none of them are stuck so far. We'll see, I'm not worried about it.
What was your mindset going into this fight?
Win by whatever means necessary. That's always the mindset going into a fight. You know, I would have liked to strike a little bit more. I would like to strike at all. But he threw one leg kick and then immediately went in on a single leg. Wouldn't let go despite the extended failed attempt. And eventually went too deep to one side, so the rear choke was there, and I just took it. So no specific mindset going in, just win by whatever means.
Yesterday at the weigh-ins, he was doing a lot of talking. What was going through your mind?
Nothing. I'm just looking through. I don't really care what he says. It makes no difference to me. It's all the same when we're in there.
What can we expect from you moving forward?
So I just called out Trevor Goody. So that'll be the next fight. Yeah, that's very exciting for welterweight, I think. And it really kind of, I think, will catapult one of us into title contention. I believe it'll catapult me into title contention. That's going to be an exciting fight. But in general, you can expect me to continue to put on exciting finishes that are supposed to be done.
Awesome. Thank you.
So Jack, my one question to you, bro, and we talked about it on your show, of how much you train, how much you skip those holiday meals and all that good stuff. Was this fight right here, like, kind of like really an upset for you? Like, you're disappointed because of, you know, how much hard work you put in and it ended so quick?
I mean, I can never say it's disappointing in that regard. You know, and even if this one ends quick, I need to have all those hard, disciplined camps in the bank so that by the time I get to the higher levels, I've been ready. And it's not like I'm playing catch up. It's like I'm on the head of the curve in that regard. So it's never a waste. You know, obviously my original opponent fell through, but it's never a waste.
Well, that's all I really have to say, man. And damn, Trevor, that was a good one for this one.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Thank you, man.
Thank you.
Over here. What was your initial reaction when your first fight fell through?
It was weird because, essentially, when you told me the news, it was like, Burbridge is out, but Ellis is on. So it was like, there was no time to be like pouty or whatever, like, oh, am I going to have a fight or not? It was like, okay, this is the new guy, so just put your focus on that guy. It's always a little bit weird, but it's happened to me several times now at this point, to where I've had opponents switch the day of. My very first amateur fight, my debut, I had like three opponents fall through the week of, and I took a new guy like a day or two beforehand, and obviously he took a fight a day or two beforehand too, but you know, whoever it is, the mindset's still the same. You gotta be good enough to be anybody.
So I asked Trevor Goody about you back, I think it was August. He said he doesn't think you're that good, you're not as well-rounded as him. What's your reaction to that?
As well-rounded? Huh. I believe he has dangerous jiu-jitsu off of his back. He's a tricky customer in that regard. I think I beat him cleanly on the feet, and that he struggles with my power.
So when should we expect to see that fight?
I don't know if, so it'll either be this next card or the one after that. So definitely this summer. I'm going to take a step back. You know, I'm not going to make the call tonight. See if my body needs to heal a little bit after this camp. And then make the decision from there. You know, I don't know what's going on with him, but I definitely want to get him in this summer.
Trevor told me he's looking for a fight in New York so he can actually use the camp that he just did. They'll be ready after that.
Cool.
All right. Congratulations.
Any shout outs?
Shout out my team, Lakeville MMA from day one. KO Gym, Lozon MMA, BTT Taunton, my sponsor of this camp, Kyler Seafood in New Bedford. You know, they helped me out big time with, you know, having that lean protein at the end of camp makes things, you know, a million times easier with my weight cut. fish is so good for, you know, recovery in terms of nutrient density. And I love fish too. Like, I love salmon, swordfish, tuna. So it's great to have them as a sponsor. So thank you, Coach Sensei John Miranda, Mike Avila, Joe Lozon, Tony Luke's here, Miguel's my main man, training partner. What's up, Justin? How's it going? Fish off, I go over here.
Oh, wow.
He's just there.
I shot him.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jack.